Hey everyone, this is going to be the Slowlist, Slowlist Coming to Your Face, with our new podcast episode. This is podcast episode number 3. We have our lovely podcast people with us. So introduce yourselves, everyone.
I'm Victoria.
Victoria, and then Tynisha.
Well, I'm Ty, aka Tynisha, you know.
Intros.
Steph, you wanna... Hello, you there? Steph?
Oh, sorry.
Oh.
Hi, guys. I didn't know, sorry. Hi, guys, I'm Stefan. I do the Midnight Hour podcast over on my channel. It's on iTunes, and I also do music covers and vlogs on YouTube. I'm not on Twitter, but I do have a Tumblr. It's Solar Flare on Tumblr. That's it.
And I am Justin. That's it. I'm just Justin.
And I'm Kat. Welcome to the Slowlist podcast. All right.
Hey.
So then,
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You'll never have the sacred stone.
Oh, this you crazy mother.
Hello everyone, we are here. Okay, we're just gonna kick. What you want to say? That? Oh, okay. We're just
hello guys, thank you for tuning in into the first podcast of Slowlist Council. My name is
Why
Justin.
Why is it playing?
Get started.
We just went into a whole new podcast.
No, Inception. Like, okay. Well, here we go.
You incepted your own podcast.
I know. How many
with
people
your
can
first podcast?
How many people can say they Kanye'd themselves?
Oh my god!
Not many people,
except Taylor Swift.
Well, she didn't do it to herself.
You don't know that.
Would she pay Kanye to do that?
I don't know. Maybe she's the one that gave Kanye the liquor in the beginning.
I'm pretty sure Kanye ain't got no problem buying the liquor. Okay, so first story is, look how depressing. Okay,
I know, right?
They really picked a depressing picture.
They did.
Alex Nash is the boy's name. So they didn't.
5 years old.
5 years old. They didn't show up to his friend's birthday party. Apparently, the parents gave him a choice. Like, you can go to the birthday party or you can go to your grandparents' house because I guess they were planning a trip to go there. So they decided to go to. He decided he wanted. Yeah, I guess I want to go see grandma. Whatever. And so they didn't go to the party, and then the parents receive a bill for $24, and then it turns to a big thing, and now the parents of the birthday person is like, oh, we're gonna sue and everything, and I'm like, relax.
For $24.
I don't know about suing, but I'd have to hear the full story first. Like, why did they get a bill in the first place? Like, was there some previous contractual agreement or?
I mean, I can say, like, honestly, birthday parties, like, if you really go all out for your kids, it's pricey as hell. Just like any sweet 16, if you RSVP for a party, you better show up. Otherwise, that's money that you just wasted by not showing up. You know, things go to waste. And that's not fair, but I think it's a little petty to send a bill if it's only $25. If maybe the person wasted like $70 or more, then I think it's more than fine to send them a bill.
Well, even still, I mean, I'd like to know all of it, because maybe they knew, like maybe the people told them beforehand, look, if you decide not to show up, we're going to have to send you a bill.
Well, the parents said that had he known that that was like a clause, he wouldn't have even went or wouldn't even have said to go.
Was it already mentioned that he would have to pay if he didn't show up?
No, he said he didn't know or he wouldn't have done it.
Okay.
It's only $25. I don't understand the whole debate. And I really think it's ridiculous when people, I guess, waste a small amount of money and then think suing for more money is the best strategy.
And at the same time, it's sort of alienating the kid a little bit. Like, from school, you know, it's kind of weird to like charge people for a party.
Yeah, because and then it makes both like kids look bad. It's like, your parents can't pay $24, but then it's like, your parents are begging for $24.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, it's ridiculous. Like, I think the amount is petty, but honestly, like, there have been so many times where like people just, you know, RSVP to a party and you pay for that extra plate, and then they don't show up. You know, and that's money that came out of your pocket now because they didn't come.
That's true.
And I also feel. Okay. And I also feel like you have to take some responsibility. Like I can understand if not one person showed up and you're like pissed off and you're like, oh, no, everyone's going to pay me for this party. But if he's literally the only person that didn't show up. OK, just pay the $24. Like,
yeah.
Why you have to go hunt him down for $24?
Exactly. Now you're just hunting this kid down that didn't do anything but visit his grandparents.
And they're five. Why do you have to throw an extravagant party? Like, give them some balloons in the backyard. It'll be the same party.
That's another thing. You know, people do too much for these kids. And it's like kids cost so much alone that it's like... anything extra better be like really like worth it, and you better have the money for it. Because then if you're going to be billing people for $25, you had no, like, you didn't have the money for this party to begin with.
Wait, do we know that the party was extravagant though? Did they say that?
It better have been something else. I would assume they're charging. It was pretty extravagant.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, but then maybe it wasn't, and she's just trying to get some, like, maybe, yeah, like, there's a feud, and she's just trying to get $24.
And then there's a quick poll. It says, what would you do? Rip it up? Rip up the invoice and laugh? Or apologize and pay up?
Like I said, I mean, I know I keep saying this, but I just really need to know more. Because it's such an extreme thing. And I feel like there's got to be so much more to the story. I mean, because like you guys are saying, I mean, it's $25, $24. So what's the big deal? But, like, I feel like there's more to... I mean, if you're going to sue somebody over $24, I feel like there's more going on.
Yeah, there's more, okay, like...
it was pretty extravagant. It was at the Plymouth Ski and Snowboard Center.
Oh, for a five-year-old?
Yeah.
They're going to be falling all the time.
They're not even going to remember any of this.
They're not. Oh, my God, that was more for the parents.
That's what it is, because she wanted to show off, oh, you're too good to come to my party.
Yes, that was exactly
it. Wow.
I mean, was it like a deposit though, the $25? Like, if you know, the people.
Oh, probably. Probably that was the deposit for each child or something.
Yeah.
But like I said, yeah, when you RSVP, you can't get out of that at that point, you know, unless you have like somebody that died.
But then you got to realize they probably wasn't thinking like that. They're five. You just drop off the kid when you're five. This is not somebody's wedding.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, this mother did the most.
The mother did the most, but I feel like RSVPs should be valued a little more. You know, I get that $25 is nothing, and I would rip it up and laugh and be like, you really want to take this to court and waste more money? Really?
But this is like, this is a problem with a lot of people. Like, they don't tell you the catch up front.
Yeah.
So, like, even, like, when you're on 14th Street, right, and those people that are selling the candy, they put the candy in your hand first and then ask you for the money. No, because I thought it was free. Don't put anything in my hand.
That's happened mm-hmm. to me when I was on the train one time. Some lady came up to me with a toy, and she gave it to me. And it looked really nice, so I was playing with it, and I said, thank you. And she was like, no, $5. I was like, what?
Girl, you can have that back.
You don't give a kid a toy and then do that to them. Like, it was messed up. Oh, jeez.
So, yeah, I do think it's a tad bit extreme. Especially, and then suing, like, is that even small claims?
Yeah, can you even sue for $25?
I mean, it's not America. I know America is like, I think 500, maybe. 200, maybe. $24. Like, I know the judge would be so, like, over it.
Yeah, just dismiss it.
Okay. I mean, but would you guys pay it or no?
I would pay it because it's only $25.
Okay.
Instead of going to court and, like, you know, I would just pay it.
Yeah. Okay, well, this next story is about two brothers in Philly. You know the, okay, so the sewer grates where the iron things on the ground? Mm-hmm. You guys know those? Mm-hmm. So they went around stealing them, and apparently they stole $500,000 worth of them.
Oh my God.
But the thing is, they're worth $475, and they sold them for $9.
Okay.
The worst business plan ever.
Those parents need to get in on this.
Maybe it was like like some Red Robin. Is that what it's called? Robin Hood or something like that kind of thing? Just like trying to make it less for other people, I guess. Yeah.
No.
I mean, because they stealing from the rich? I mean, that's just...
No, they're stealing from us, basically.
Yeah, the city.
Because we got to pay for it.
Yeah, those are city grates. Maybe that's why MTA wants to raise up prices, to pay for Philly's missing grates.
Yeah.
But I mean, what are they... Who's buying the... You know, the grates.
The scrap metal dealer.
So it's like a chop shop, but for like metal. Yeah.
But
well,
I just
kind of dumb then.
Okay, each one weighs 100 pounds. So I'm like, the physical work and the risk of being arrested for stealing public property. It's just like, who did the math in this equation?
They didn't. I don't think they really did their research. This was just something where they were like, we just need like quick like crack money. Because that's really what it is. $9 for something that was 100 pounds? No, that doesn't add up at all. That's not even like, that's not even a dollar a pound.
Well, that's not a quick crack money, because how many did they steal?
They stole like maybe 100 or 500 maybe.
Yeah, they said around 500.
That's a lot of work.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that means they move like...
So I'm like, you really didn't even research how much it would cost or anything like that. You just stole them and then went on stealing another.
It had to be easier to just apply for like a job for the Department of Transportation or something. Like, and then, so we did the math, right? And apparently they made about $4,500 approximately. And their bail was $10,000 and they couldn't pay it. It's just
well, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Really unfortunate. Oh, I don't know. I'm sorry. But I don't know what Philly is doing over there. I guess we can go to the next story because now this one I hear echo. Anybody? Oh. Okay. So this next door. Oh, I didn't mean to mouth pop like that. Oh. Okay. So teen in Florida. I always have to shout out that it's Florida because Florida has the craziest stories. He poses as a doctor, a OBGYN, for a month. And then finally someone's like, wait, who are you? Uh, And he's a teen, like he's young. They don't say his name, so I'm assuming he's under 18.
Yeah.
That's probably minor. And the hospital said the individual never had contact with any hospital patients and did not gain access to any patient care areas of the hospital at any time. The hospital immediately notified local authorities who took the individual into custody, and we are cooperating with them with their ongoing investigation. I doubt he was there walking in the waiting room.
Yeah. I mean, a whole month? How do you get away with that for a whole month?
He was like, no one said, hey, no one like is like, hey, who is this?
Yeah, who's this new person? Or, I mean, something.
I know we all talk about people at our job.
Yeah.
So.
And no one said, I feel like someone had to notice that. How did they end up finding out he wasn't working there?
Let me see. Oh no, okay, this is where the hospital statement kinda contradicts itself. So apparently he was inside the examination room with a patient, with a doctor, and then I guess that doctor was like, "Whoa." So
he did see patients then. So yeah, like you said, that was contradictory because they just said that he hadn't had any contact, right?
Yeah, they said not even just that. They said he wasn't in any patient areas.
Oh no, that's definitely a patient area. If you're sitting in there with the doctor.
Yeah, like he just dressed up as a doctor and was in the lobby.
And like, he was just chilling. Wow, see, you know, it's funny. Stuff is just, people always think like stuff is so hard to get into or so inaccessible, but really, like, if you just act like you belong there, it's really easy to get into stuff. Like, for instance, you know, the White House, that thing that happened a while ago where that couple just walked in.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you could just, I mean, it's not that hard.
Yeah, because people are trained to look for people that don't belong. So if you look like you work here,
they just let it go. Yeah. They just don't even think twice.
Apparently, his mother said that he has a mental illness and he's not taking his medicine.
Yeah, right. I feel like, okay, why is it like every time somebody does something that's messed up and they get caught, they'll be like, oh, he's not right in the head and stuff like that. It's like, how do you be so not right in the head that you can perfectly pretend like you are a doctor and stay there for a month? Like, that's somebody that has a plan. Usually mentally ill people are just like, they don't know how to like be like to pretend like they can pretend, but like, I don't know. I feel like that's impossible for him to be mentally ill and pull that off.
I mean, well, like, mental illness, though, it's a pretty wide range of things. It's not always necessarily, like, being addled or something, you know? Like, you could still be functional and still be mentally ill. It's just, you know, there are different types.
Yeah, it doesn't always diminish, capability.
Yeah.
Sometimes it
That's what I'm saying. Like, if you're going to use that, you're making it like it seems like he's trying to use it like he didn't know what he was doing, kind of thing.
I really think that was just like a cover up, because usually people that, you know, don't want to get in as much trouble say something about their psyche, you know?
Well, I think it also like is they're saying like it diminishes like morality or like what's right and what's wrong. Maybe he didn't like, I guess she was trying to say maybe he didn't even know he was doing something wrong. He probably just thought maybe it was just fun.
Oh,
I have no idea.
I don't know, but
I mean, but it is Florida at the same time.
Yeah, and where is all the security for this? Like, I don't blame security guards themselves, but just honestly, like, people should know, okay, I didn't see this guy training at this hospital before. Who is he?
But at the same, you can't, I can't blame the security guards, because if he walked in with a white coat, especially if it's like because it's a medical center, which are usually the bigger ones, who was the security guard to say, hey, do you work here?
More or less supervisors.
Yeah, I would blame the supervisor. Yeah. Like that, because they're supposed to be in charge of the staff. They're supposed to know everybody.
Yeah, that makes more sense. Supervisor, yeah, like, can you walk down the hallway one time and see him in a room and like, excuse me.
He wore a mask on his face? Then it wasn't just for fun. Like, he knew he was hiding.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, how can you pull the mental illness card and you...
Exactly, like, a mental illness, if you don't know that you're doing something wrong, then you don't think that showing your face would give any consequences.
Yeah.
Like, he clearly knew that he was young and that he was not a doctor, so he put a mask on his face. I can't believe that.
I mean, I guess we're getting into the conversation of, does mental illness... Do you know that there's consequences? But I think you know that there's consequences. There's plenty of mental ill people that run and hide because they know there's consequences.
Yeah, I think in some way, you know.
Well, sorry. I don't know. Oh, no. No. I was going to say, it's hard for me to comment on it just because I've never been mentally ill. I don't know anyone who's mentally ill. So it's like... I don't have that firsthand experience to say whether, you know, or not that's like a real reason or excuse. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I know people have problems, but I don't know if that's enough to say he can't be held responsible for that.
Like, if you had, like, I don't know, multiple personality disorder in which you think that you're several different people, even those people, they don't hide their face because they think that whoever they think they are, they really think that's who they are at the moment. So.
It might still be a delusion because, okay, so after they, like, busted him or they came into the room wherever he was, he presented himself, he said, I'm Dr. Robinson.
So, I mean, that's something I would do if I was him and somebody came and questioned me. I would make up a name too. I'd be like, oh snap, I'm this person, whatever, because you know you're about to get in trouble.
But if we're at the end of the Scooby-Doo episode and they're pulling off the mask, what else can you do? Like, you can't just keep going.
I don't know.
I mean, that's why I feel like it is mental illness. If you still keep going,
that comes into question. If liars, do liars ever stop lying, even if they get caught? No, they still try to cover it up. Like, no, I'm not lying, kind of thing. Like, they are just.
Of all doctors, he pretended to be. It was an OBGYN doctor.
Yeah.
Like, had he really like gone in with this? Like, he really like. Oh my God, so many women could have sued him for so many things.
Because he wanted to see, I think that's really what his plan was. He wanted to see when to look up in somebody's stuff. So he pretended to be a doctor and didn't work out because he didn't get to that point yet. Like,
or he watched the Cosby Show and he put two and two together.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Oh God.
Terrible.
I'm sorry. Okay, next story is, he failed at it.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah, he failed.
Okay. So this guy in the pizza shop, he tries to rob a pizza shop by writing a note to the pizza, to the guy at the counter and it on toilet paper. And it says, I have a gun. Give me $300. First of all, who robs a pizza shop like that? He's like the bank, like you do that at the bank because there's armed security guards.
Yeah. And also like silent security alarms.
Yeah. And then, yeah, you don't want to alert the other teller who can hit the silent alarm.
Did he at least have like a gun or anything?
I actually don't know if he actually had a gun.
That would be way
I
more
doubt
charges.
It if he didn't do it.
So wait, you said he gave him a piece of toilet paper?
Yeah, with a note. Like he wrote the note on toilet paper.
Wait. So he bombed a place.
He tried to rob the place.
Yeah, he tried to rob the place with like a written note on toilet paper. So he basically just gave the person at the cash register like a piece of toilet paper with a note on it.
Well, he didn't rob the place because the police came because the employee hit the panic button.
Well, okay. I feel like I've heard of this before.
Oh, there's been plenty of stupid people that tried to rob them.
No, I mean, like, somebody has did this. They've written on a toilet paper, and then, like, they tried to do that, and then it still didn't work. And then now, like, I guess history repeats itself, because this is exactly what this person did. And the police just showed, like, did they just show up? They were just like, oh, he put the paper in, and they pressed the panic button, and then as he's walking out, they walk in, or how did that happen?
Yeah, they arrived before he could leave.
That is so difficult.
Which I mean, unless the precinct or a police officer was like, because you know, I got to go to 911. I mean, the 911 has to get the call, then you got to hit dispatch, and then they got to hit a squad. So. I mean, yeah, a car could have been in the area, or he just took a long time. And then I guess they got a search warrant for his house, and they found
the exact 2-ply that he used to write the note.
That's where they said they found a newly opened roll of toilet paper. With the pen impression from Faye's note on an outer sheet.
I can't. This guy really couldn't find paper or even a napkin.
That's what I was thinking. Like, you could have picked, like, anything else.
It's kind of smart at the same time. Because, I mean, yeah, you can get rid of paper, but not as easily as you can get rid of toilet tissue. Like, you just flush it, it's done. Like, there's nothing else to do.
I guess, yeah, it's done. And also, like, okay, well, I didn't buy this exact sheet of paper that you think I used to write this note. Like, everybody buys toilet paper. You can't blame me for that. That's a really good defense, too. But I don't know. I was just like, this whole thing, and you wrote it on toilet paper. I want to know what the 300 was for. Because 300 for a pizza shop seems a little pricey.
Maybe it was really expensive. Like, you know how some pizza shops have, like, extra stuff? Like, desserts and everything? So, that racks up the price and stuff. I know downstairs at, you know, Catalina, like, where I used to live at? That pizza shop, like, a pie is, like, $20 and up. So, that's just a pie, a regular pie. So.
Well, this guy really
nailed it.
Okay, so, I have been hinting towards this, but here we go. Bill Cosby.
Okay.
I don't know what everyone's thoughts on this are, but. Here's the little video. I hope you guys can hear it. Let me know if you can hear it, if you can't.
Yeah, I can hear it.
It was really loud. I wasn't expecting it.
We found from 1991. Bill Cosby was on CNN promoting a book. He tells an interesting story. Take a look.
Spanish fly was the thing that all boys from age 11 on up to death. We will still be searching for Spanish fly.
That's right.
And what was the old story was, if you took a little drop, no, it was on the head of a
pin.
That's right.
Drop
and you
it
put
in
it
a
in
Coca-Cola.
A drink.
Don't Cut. Matter.
It doesn't make it. And the girl would drink it, and
she's yours.
Hello, America.
Oh, wow.
Oh. Yep.
He really said that. Oh, my
yep.
God. Like, I was thinking, like, oh, you know, people are just exaggerating. But he really said this out of his mouth. Like, this is for real.
I mean, in his defense, Spanish Fly isn't what people are claiming that he used on them. But if he's willing to publicly say something like this, because I don't like when I'm making a drink for someone, anything extra but the drink is like, that's on you. So, like, if he's going to publicly say this, what would he do privately?
Well, did you guys see that that video of him on Dr. Phil?
No.
Kissing the little girl? So, I mean...
Yeah, that already sounds weird.
No, he was... he kissed her on the cheeks, on her but it was just... It was kind of awkward, I guess. And, I mean, I'm not trying to say that that meant anything, but it was just kind of, like, off... to me.
Yeah, I think it's like anything he does with like women now will be seen as really awkward because of this whole thing. You know? Yeah. So even like the little things, like I'm pretty sure when he was like really famous for the Cosby Show around that time, like he could kiss a girl on the cheek and it would be like, "Oh my god, she's so lucky." But now
I don't think
like,
anybody ever said that.
Bill, stop. Stop.
Well, I guess what was weird about it was after he kissed her on both her cheeks, like I guess he had tasted her and he's like, "Oh, you eat a lot of salt, don't you?" I guess she tasted salty. So that was what was kind of off, I guess, to me.
Yeah, that's pretty weird.
And I mean, if you look up the video, I don't know, I mean, like, maybe it is just that thing that, well, now that this has happened, it seems more weird than it is, so that could be it.
Yeah,
I
do think that's true. Too. You can go, Steph.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the whole thing pretty much changes, like, the whole perception that you have of Bill Cosby. Like, even if you, like, when you consider the fact that there hasn't been, like, any official proof against him, but still, it changes your mind about Bill Cosby. Like, you think about him differently. So when he does something like that, it's, like, kind of weird.
Yeah, he hasn't come out and said anything yet, right?
Yeah. I think it's the lack of evidence that's making everybody so, like, skeptical about everything he does now. So it's like, we don't know. We don't really want to believe it, but anything you do now, we're watching.
Okay, two things about being skeptical. Yeah, I feel the same way, because I never thought of him. You know, on the Cosby Show, you never think. But then I'm like, oh, he was an OBGYN. Like he delivered baby. Like, that's all he did was look at, you know, lady parts all day. That's kind of creepy now. And then the second thing is, he did make a little joke and said, like, "Oh, you don't want me to make you a drink for you." And this was in a recent stand-up.
Oh my god.
Well, he's old now, so it's kind of sit down.
Wow.
Oh, shade.
He's stupid.
Shade.
So shady.
I mean, but was he actually making a joke, or was he just kind of being like, you know, kind of sarcastic, saying, you know, because everybody's on his back about it.
Yeah, I do think it was a joke. I don't think he was like.
I don't even think like it's a joking matter for him to make, like, you know what I mean? Like, he shouldn't be joking about it, even though he's trying to make light of it. It's like a big scandal. He shouldn't.
Yeah, it's like there are some scandals you can take lightly and joke about. Like, if a nude photo leaked out about you and be like, "Whoops, I guess you guys see it all now. Whoops, shouldn't have done that." But then it's like you can't be talking about things like that. Like, well, I would always wish, since I was 11 years old, for this Spanish Fly. Or you can't make a joke like that. That's not lightening the mood. That's like, wow, you're really this insane.
I don't think it was as creepy as the R. Kelly interview when the guy asked them,
"Oh my god, yeah.
Do you like young girls or teen girls?" And he's like, "How old are you talking about?"
Oh my god.
And it's like, why do people dig themselves in the holes? Just like.
Like, it.
Like, at least this kid was pretending to be a doctor and did it well for a month. Go on one interview and call yourself out.
Yeah. And it's like the father from Seventh Heaven, the guy that was like, came out as like a pedophile.
Yeah.
Like, you can't make jokes like that, and it's just weird to me.
He's not making jokes. That's the thing. Like, Bill Cosby's being accused too. He hasn't said anything personally about it, but he's making jokes.
Yeah, but I mean,
and people are finding things. Yeah,
that made me think of an interesting point, because a lot of people Are saying, oh, well, how come Seventh Heaven didn't get pulled from places and stuff like that?
Yeah, I was just about to say that.
But,
they pulled Cosby stuff off, like, with the quickness, and his stuff is still playing.
I mean,
You know, I was actually thinking about that the other day, how, because that guy actually came out, did an interview, kind of admitting all that he had done, and then it kind of blew over, like, it almost never happened.
It's messed up.
Yeah. And Woody Allen, like, has, a new special coming out on Amazon. Yeah, it's like a double standard, I think.
But I also want to make a point of, we didn't know about, what's his name, Steven something? We didn't know about any of that. So how come people are like, there's so many people that's like, oh, Bill Cosby is a conspiracy. And I'm like, who has Bill Cosby ever been to do a 40-year conspiracy against? Like, is he secretly running some country that I don't know about or has armies or something? Like, what, why are we taking down Bill Cosby?
How did this even start again? I forget.
Comedian Hannibal
Buress.
Yeah.
Yeah. He did a stand up thing, made a joke about it.
And then everyone was like, oh, here we go. It only takes one incident, just like Paula Deen. Okay. It only takes one little comment.
Yeah.
Now everyone's looking through all of his past interviews, his episodes, and everything just to see where he kind of slips up.
But, I mean, I guess we always do that, though. Just like when somebody's a serial killer or somebody's a spree shooter or something, we always go, well, wait, did we miss the signs or were there any signs?
Yeah, because then we kind of put it on us to blame. Like, we should have seen this coming. Like, we put so much fame into this guy's, like, lap. Well, he was putting other things on his lap.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, God.
All right, terrible joke. Anyways, about the drinks again. I don't even like when I make coffee, I just make the pot of coffee, whatever you want to add to it, that milk and sugar, I don't ask you. You do that. All right? I don't even have people put in my sugar for my coffee. I'm just like, that's all me.
I don't know. I think... when, you know, you guys talking about people looking back at past stuff and kind of pulling stuff up. Honestly, I think we sometimes, like, make stuff more than it is. Because at the time, if people didn't think that was weird, you know, and now they do just because this happened. But if this never happened, it never would have been weird. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know.
Yeah, but another thing is, if he's making all these crazy jokes about putting things in women's drinks while they, like, fall asleep from it, we, like, blame ourselves because now we've got these alleged victims. And these things would probably not have happened had people had seen these interviews in a more serious light.
But the thing is, though, he's a comedian. Like, how many comedians make up messed up jokes just like that? Like, maybe not necessarily about drugging people's drinks. But I mean, I hear comedians make really messed up jokes like
exactly.
all the time.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but
I'm a big fan of Shane Dawson.
Exactly. So as many times as comedians make like crazy jokes, like we'll always, you know, think, okay, it's all part of the comedy. But when something else happens, then we look back and we're like, damn, you know, comedian was really taking advantage that we only took, you know, only laugh from this, you know.
And it also depends on the comic. So like if like a Joan Rivers said something outrageous, that's a lot different than a Bill Cosby, who's very clean with his comedy.
Yeah.
So it's like, and then you also got like Larry King joking like he did it too. Like maybe that was the thing back in the day.
Yeah. That's hard, you know. Because, I mean, I couldn't say every comic who makes up messed up jokes like that is necessarily a predator. You know what I'm saying? Like, because that would be a lot of comedians.
Yeah.
And people, I mean, but the thing is also, people laugh at this. It's not like they're saying it and people are all offended. I mean, there's a whole audience of people that are condoning it and laughing along with them. So, I mean, does that make the audience, you know, predators too in a sense? Because they think it's funny?
Yeah. And, I mean, I don't think that, you know, comedians should stop joking. I just think there has to be a little bit more boundaries now. with the jokes because, I don't know, things about rape, that's not really funny.
Yeah.
Things about murder, that's not funny. I'm pretty sure if you really were a good comedian, you could make me laugh without having to bring up something crude. Yes.
Some things are, like, never murder, funny.
Murder, like, it depends on the context of murder. Like, because...
I'm gonna have to agree with
Tanisha. Yeah, bad guy kind of thing. Like, depending on if we're, like, talking about a bad guy being murdered or something like that. Like, I don't know.
It depends on who you are. Like...
But I think that rape is not funny in any context.
Yeah, so that's why when Bill Cosby makes a joke about putting something in a woman's drink, I don't think because he's a comedian, we should be like, oh, it's just, you know, fun and games. You know, that's something like, Bill, I think you went across the line there.
But that's why I say it depends on who you are. So, like, if Hitler makes a joke about killing people, whoa. You know? Bill Cosby before post rape stuff, okay, maybe, but after now you come, like, if you're a serial rapist, I don't want to hear you joke about rape.
Yeah.
Because you take that stuff seriously, like, you do that you think that's part of your job.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a serial rapist, so I but if, like, if you just, yeah, I have a morbid sense of humor, so I'll laugh at anything if it's, you know, depending on what it is.
I guess, like, we all have our type of sense of, like, I guess humor. You know, I like some dark jokes myself, but
yeah,
I don't know. It's just, when you're, like, a real comedian and you're famous for making people laugh, I think there has to be, like, real boundaries.
And it's not even just comedians either. I mean, you know, I personally don't think rape jokes are funny, but... you know, there are people, like, for instance, I don't know if you guys heard about, was it CeeLo and Rick Ross? Didn't they both have songs out that kind of talked about date rape?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if CeeLo had a song, but CeeLo, he got in trouble for it.
Yeah.
But I may be saying.
But Rick Ross definitely, Molly, whatever, that Molly song.
Yeah, he had a song about it.
So he had a song about it, okay.
Yeah.
But they had both been kind of involved in something to do with it. And, you know, it's some people just think it's like it's not a big deal, you know, it's just a thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I think that's more the issue than, you know, whether it's in a joke or not.
Yeah, I do agree with that.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if he did it. I can't see 20 people lying.
Yeah.
Not on Bill Cosby, because what are you going to gain? Like, who's going to be like, oh, come do a show. Bill Cosby raped you.
Yeah.
Like,
what are they trying to get out of it, though?
But that's like, what I'm saying. Like, nobody's really asking for anything. Like, yeah, he settled in 2006, but that's about it.
Yeah. Not only that, but, like, all of their, I guess, like, time is up for, like, you know, putting this into trial. So it's like, you really couldn't do anything about it.
And how do you guys feel about settling? Like, do you think innocent people still settle?
I do. Especially when they have a certain level of, like, celebrity and a certain amount of money. Sometimes I'm thinking it's probably just easier to do that rather than go through the bad publicity and go through the drama mm-hmm. of a trial.
Not only that, but, like, I think it's only better to settle when most of the evidence is, like, on you, you know? Because sometimes they can really, like, change around, you know, maybe the defense is really good on their side, and it's just, like, you know, I probably should settle just because this could just backlash on me.
Do you guys think Michael Jackson did it?
Oh, my God.
I couldn't say either way, actually, to be honest.
And it's just because this is like the Michael Jackson of our time.
Yeah.
Like the Michael, you know, that type of scandal. Like someone who's always been
pretty clean.
Yeah,
pretty
clean, like,
you know, innocent. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And like Bill Cosby was everybody's father.
Oh my God.
Okay. Well, you know, I mean, like, he was like TV's father. He was like TV's favorite dad.
As long as it's not the Seventh Heaven guy, that's my dad. Oh, okay.
And you know what's even worse about that story is just like he was in court, like, I'm not in arbitration. So, like, they forced him to say, have to say those things.
What do you mean?
Like, he, I don't know if he's in a divorce proceeding or whatever, but he was, you know, arbitration.
Seventh heaven guy.
Yeah, like, so they were at the table with a judge, and he had to tell the truth.
Oh.
So that's why all of that stuff came out. And it did kind of, I don't know if it went over because, like, he just wasn't ever really that relevant.
He's not relevant, and also it, I don't know, it's not enough, but I think because he came out a little more clean about it, that it just kind of seems like...
Oh, yeah, there's not, like, speculation. Yeah, like, people
there's
aren't
no
like, well,
speculation. Like, he came out right away with it and was like, you know, but this happened. Not right away, but it just a lot sooner than Bill Cosby's allegations.
I mean, and they also pulled, like, the Seventh Heaven episodes off the air, too, so it's kind of the same thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't even know they were still playing.
Exactly.
I don't agree with pulling the shows.
Some channels are still playing it.
I don't agree with pulling the shows because, like, everyone on the show gets a check. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't care if the star of the show did, cut their check.
Was everyone he really else... the star?
Who?
He's the dad.
Yeah, he was the
he
dad.
He was the dad, but wasn't it about everyone else, though?
No, he was the reverend. And I think that's creepy, too, that he was the reverend.
Oh, God. Oh, my gosh. He was a reverend, and then Bill Cosby was an OGBYN. Like, really?
I think we need to start. You see, my wife and kids, he's fine because he wasn't any. He was just he just owned a truck company.
Yeah.
So he's fine. What other dads?
I don't know, but we're going to have some guy that's like a police officer that murders people, apparently.
That already happens.
What, in a show?
Oh, well, I was talking about real life. But,
well, yeah, it happens in real life, but it's like creepier with the shows.
Yeah. Okay, the next story is the boxing guy, boxing
champ. Jermaine Taylor.
Is he really a boxing champ, or is it like a porn star? Because, you know, we call everybody, like, everybody that does porn is a porn star, but, like, there's just people that just do porn. Like, everyone's not a star.
Wait, but he is a boxing champ, though.
No, yeah. I mean, like, is he a boxing champ? You know, how, I'm just saying, like, is a boxing champ, is it just that a term that they call boxers? Or is he literally, did he win?
I mean, well, then what are all those guys doing behind him? Is this, like, a
There's always
screenshot?
A bunch of people. There's always a bunch of people when they do the weigh-ins. I don't know.
Weigh-ins for
no,
a porno?
Let me explain. Let me explain.
Are we talking right. about boxers or?
No, I'm talking about the term boxing champ because the headline says boxing champ. I just wanted to know if he's really a champion.
Well, it says boxer's championship belt. I don't remember pornos giving you a championship belt.
No, but we always call anybody who does porn a porn star.
Yes.
Okay, so but they're just like, what about they're not a star?
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah,
oh,
like
that as an analogy. That's yeah. not actually related to
okay.
I'm not saying he did porn. I'm saying
okay. So he's just a boxing opponent. Just a boxing opponent. A random guy.
A boxer.
Boxer, whatever.
Anyway.
Okay. Yeah.
Wow, that was a really big side note.
Yeah, I did not pick up on that at all.
Okay.
Yeah, anyways, the boxer.
People.
Well, he did get a belt, though, so he kind of is a champ. Not
yeah,
like,
I don't know how boxing works, so.
Oh, look at that picture. Look at his ribs. It just looks like look somebody's at, holding his ribs.
Where is his nipples?
He's so like, small.
He ain't got no nipples. But anyway.
Is that
so,
why he mad?
I mean, he might be. So no, it says he's mad because because his son dropped the championship belt. Well, maybe he thought you didn't deserve it.
What, he dropped a belt?
How can you get? And yeah, so he dropped the belt and then
your
he pointed
son is five.
Look, he pointed a gun at a five-year-old, three-year-old, and a one-year-old and his wife, and fired shots in the air.
What the hell?
Oh, wait, why? Because they dropped the belt?
Mm-hmm. I'm guessing the son dropped the belt, right? This is my theory. The son dropped the belt. He gets mad at the kid. Mother's like, hey, calm down. He's like, really? You know? And
this
just,
was my one win ever.
Mm-hmm.
No one knows who I am still.
I was just a boxer yesterday. Now I'm a champ. And
it's like, you're not even a great person.
I mean, a lot of people that do like physical sports, like, they're very aggressive.
Aggressive, but my God, when you're a boxer, you really need a gun?
But I mean, aggressive people like guns.
I can't, especially when you're in a household with all these kids. Like, it should be like far away as possible. Like you know, you were irresponsible when you put your belt at eye level with your 5-year-old. Like, how were they able to drop it? You didn't even put it in a safe spot. It was just wherever, and it dropped. And now you bring out a gun.
And then apparently he's already, like, in court for gun charges already.
Was it registered?
I don't know. Probably. I mean, if you're rich, it doesn't, like, it's not a problem to register. But, like, he already had an incident with a gun before.
Yeah.
And he was already in court for that.
Look at this. I don't understand how... This is what I really hate. I really hate when you have charges against you for a gun issue, and then you're allowed to leave with that gun.
Well, I don't know.
I feel like there should be a lot more process to getting a gun and also keeping a gun.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I mean, people take that Second Amendment
way too loosely, and I'm just like,
no, they take it literal, like, bare arms. They're like, and it's like, that amendment is like, no, that's the way it's supposed to be, and every other amendment is like, well, maybe, especially freedom of speech. Well, maybe you can talk.
Freedom of speech still has limitations. It's got more limitations than it is to bear arms.
That's what I mean. Like, that's bearing arms is the only one people are so literal on.
Exactly.
I mean,
what do you guys think about this?
I think it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Pointing a gun at your kids and your wife over something like that.
On Martin Luther King Day, by the way.
Aw, come on.
The irony in these stories, yeah. I can't. Okay, we can go to the next one. Oh, okay. This one is... So these two kids, right? I mean, not these two kids. These two parents. They went on vacation... it's a weird vacation. I don't know who goes on vacation for 2 months, but they left their kids at home, 2 9-year-olds at home alone.
What?
For 2 months.
It says for 4 months. What?
That's insane.
Oh, I thought the story said 2 months.
Oh. Well, I guess it was 2 months until the grandfather came and found them, maybe.
Yeah.
Okay. But, yeah, they were gone for 4 months. Wow.
Oh, come on. Okay, they're not even, like, they don't even care about the kids. Like, $500 bail. What is that?
Wow. I think child neglect, like, has to be a little more serious as well.
But why?
Like, you really, like, you can afford a trip to where? Africa?
Mm-hmm, Nigeria.
For 4 months, but you can't take care of your kids.
So what happened to the parents?
Well, he's on bail, so I'm guessing they still got to go to court.
I mean, like, were the kids taken away from them? Or?
Mm-hmm, they're in protective custody.
Okay, good.
I just think this is crazy. 2 months?
Yeah.
I mean, if they were teenagers... Yeah, that would be amazing, because that a nice vacation from your parents for 2 months.
Especially you. Like, you have the house to yourself and everything.
But at 9?
Even teenagers, that's too much.
I think if you gave me the right amount of money and I had a job, like, I'd be set. As long as you took care of the rent and the electricity before you went.
I don't know, like 14, 13, that's way too young.
Yeah,
like,
that's gone.
I was talking about like 16, 17.
Oh, yeah, that's different.
I mean, well,
that's like made.
Yeah, because you're like almost out on your own anyway.
This kind of reminds me of that story, well, that movie. I don't know if you guys are into like foreign films, but there's this Japanese movie called Nobody Knows, where basically it's a child abandonment case. Like, this lady left, like, her 3-4 kids by themselves, and she just left them. Like, she didn't come back, though, I don't think. Or she came back after, like, several months. It wasn't just, like, 2 or 4 months. And it was, like, really sad. But anyway, that just popped into my head.
I read a book. We actually read a book in middle school, Justin, from Miss Kabadi's class. It was called, like, Monkey Island or something.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. Because I wrote that stupid essay, and she was like, no.
Yeah, the book was about this kid that wakes up. You know, his family, like, it was just him and his mother at the time, and they didn't have a lot of money at all. So he wakes up, and his mother's not home. So he thinks, okay, maybe she just went to work. Hours go by, and he just kind of finds that she just left him maybe like a couple of, like a little box of stale donuts on the table. And he's there for a while, and he just kind of notices, like, she's not coming back. And I think somehow he found himself out on the streets being taken care of by, like, these two homeless people. And, I mean, it was nothing wrong, but it was just, like, the idea of, like, how kids kind of, like, go about, like, being abandoned. Like, what do they do next?
Okay, a little update, because I didn't read the bottom of the article. So apparently they did leave the kids with a relative. Well, a relative was supposed to come.
Aw, come on.
But didn't, like, come as much as they thought they were going to come. Which, I mean, you still check in with the kids and the relative. Like, if the kids say, hey, they ain't coming,
but
then
wait,
we need to come home.
Wait, so the relative would just come for, like, once every, like, 2-3 days? Like, what is that?
It says he checked on the boys 3 days a week.
What? How
it
do you
says
even,
that.
Why didn't you try lying? Oh, my God.
Yeah, because, like, okay, so the boys are eating, you know, breakfast and lunch at school, right? You come after work. So that means you most likely work Monday to Friday.
Mm-hmm.
But what do they do on the weekends?
Exactly. Not only that, but, like, these kids are 9 years old. Like, you're supposed to be with them at all times. Like, what if something happened? What if the house caught on fire?
And what about some
like
predator found out that they were alone?
Exactly.
And was like, oh, you know.
Guess what day it is?
Oh my God.
Oh. See, that was a rape joke.
I'm sorry. I told you, I've still got like a little sense of humor myself. I do apologize if I offend anybody, even any viewers for this podcast. I do apologize.
Well, listeners. But apparently, okay, the boys were initially taken into protective custody, but they are back with their parents. And no charges.
What?
Will be filed.
Nah, son. This guy's getting a $24 bill.
I mean, the kid. What? this is sad. This is they found no edible food in the refrigerator and only ramen noodles in the cabinet.
So these kids were basically boiling water on their own. Like, that's pretty scary. Like I said, the house could have caught on fire. Somebody could have slipped in the tub.
Yeah, because it's like this little things kids can do to mess up. Like,
exactly. They can drop belts.
You said they were 9?
Yeah.
And they're, well, at 9 years old, I was making food, so.
And to be fair, you can live on ramen noodles for like 2 months.
Not 4.
But that's harsh. I mean, when you're 9, you don't want to eat ramen noodles every day.
Exactly. You should be taken care of.
I wouldn't
want to
do that. No.
I mean, they made it to school every day.
And that just shows how innocent and how, like,
right, they don't even know that they're being mistreated.
Exactly. They didn't understand this. They saw it as something normal, which is just terrible to me. You know, like, people gotta step up and actually be parents.
But what about
what
like
did they
the
go
last
to Africa for, honestly?
What if, like, okay.
I'm sorry, I'm mad.
Well, there's like the latchkey kids. Remember that like generation where they had to like come home and stuff by themselves and just lock the door and stuff while their parents went out to work?
That was me. Yeah.
So
I was a latchkey kid.
So, I mean,
I mean, I guess, but I don't know. If you tell somebody to, like, take care of your kid, like, it has to be somebody that you really trust.
Yeah, but then it's like, sure, you got to come home, make sure you're safe when you're home. But then mom comes home, make sure you did your homework, make sure you cleaned up, whatever, make sure. You know, it's like.
Like, they're 9 years old.
Yeah, there was still some parenting.
Yeah. Like, okay, I can understand if you didn't go there that often, if it was a dog or a cat, but two human children.
And what about, like,
there was cleaning involved. There was eating involved. They went to school. They had to, you know, it's even laundry. Like, what? Really?
Yeah,
are you not there for all this?
And they call, and something happens at school. They call the emergency number. Oh, we need you to come down to the school. Oh, okay, I'll be there in a minute. I'm in Africa.
Exactly.
Like,
I'll be there in a minute. I'm in Africa. Said no one ever.
All right, so then this next story is infuriating too. The MTA raises fares once again. It's just like a yearly thing now.
Okay, yeah, so how much is it now?
It's $2.75 a ride.
$2.75.
Oh my God, they have got the game messed up. Is that just for a single ride?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, single ride isn't single ride like a quarter more anyway? Like a literal single ride from the machine is a quarter more anyway. So
yeah,
it's
so
probably
$3. Yeah.
But the initial fare is just $2.75.
So is the weekly ones and the monthly ones?
All of them are going up.
Scroll up.
All of them.
30-day goes up to $116.50. Weekly goes up to $31.
Everything changed.
Oh my gosh.
And you know, my mom used to tell me the bus used to be 10 cents.
Wow.
And I'm like, and she said, oh yeah, if you the movies used to be $5 and you could see two. And
I saw a picture that somebody posted where it was like how it increased through each year. Like 1 year it was like 10 cents, and like it just went up every year. And I just think like every year it's going to keep going up.
And it's like, where's the money going? Because like, I like that. I mean, the
service
MTA,
is still crappy.
The MTA is one of the best in like the country. But it's not like amazing. It's not like, please come. You got to come here and check this train out. It's like, no.
It's okay.
Like, it's okay.
Like every other country has faster, more efficient trains.
Yeah, our infrastructure sucks in general.
And it's disgusting.
Yeah, like Justin said, like the service isn't matching up with the price increase that they're doing. Like, the service is still the same. Like, they're not getting better. They're not improving anything. They're just raising the price each year.
Yeah, and wasn't there a so-on-so, like, debt that we had to pay off? Like, by this time, we should have had any debt ever paid off.
Well, any debt they get, they take from the government anyway. So, like, they're asking for $15 billion from state.
All I'm saying is, I think this money is just going to something else. I don't know what it is, but I know that it's definitely
going
to somewhere
else. Like, I'm just hoping, right, there's some secret project, right, that we just don't know about, and they're just putting all the money into it, and then they're going to amaze us, and we're going to be like, look, New York City, the future.
You know, do they have that automated Metro card in New York City?
What's automated?
What's that?
Yeah, it's like on your phone. Like, you can buy Metro cards on your phone.
No. I don't know.
Long Island.
How can you do that on your phone?
Like, you buy Metro cards on your phone and you just show the driver your phone instead of having a Metro card.
Oh, no, we don't do that here. We have the select bus, which means the bus driver, which means there's more chance for the bus driver to leave you because you have to pay outside.
Mm-hmm. Which is ridiculous.
It's so anti-New York.
It is.
And I think they really think, oh, well, we added some new buses.
We added some new buses. We gave you guys some timers to show that your train is delayed.
I mean, it's small changes, though. Like, it's nice that the you know, new transit is like, oh, it's 4 minutes away, whatever. And it's like, oh, the train is arriving. I mean, that's cool. But, like, you could have bended that. That's nothing.
Exactly.
You, like, put a little GPS in the train, and there you go.
That's not that impressive.
Are they trying to give the employees more money? Like, what is this? What is this?
That's what maybe Justin and I were speculating. Like, maybe they really do want to pay their workers a little bit more. But I feel like with even a $2 fare, especially for tourists and, you know, people getting, you know, jacked from their money and stuff, but broken machine and all that, like, they are making millions every day. They are making millions every day. Every day. So I have no idea why they would need us to pay more.
But, like, the thing is, like, the MTA is so massive. Because, like, in the article, it says the Long Island Railroad is going up. Metro North is going up. Every bridge is going up. The Easy Pass is going up. So,
like, I would say the Long Island Railroad is actually a lot better than the MTA. Like, the buses and stuff. So, I wouldn't mind if that price went up.
Okay. Well,
at least you benefit.
Yeah. well, at least there's something. I mean, it's not terrible, because, like, it could be like other cities where it's just like, whoa, we're not waiting hours for buses. It's not terrible, but it's just, I'm going to need the price increase to match, like, quality increase.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, maybe they're going to, like, you have to see. You have to give them time. Give them like a year or two.
They should be telling us, though. They should really be telling us.
It's been going up since forever.
Yeah.
It used to be 10 cents.
It used to have tokens, too.
Yeah, so it was from 10 cents. Then we got those new trains with the blue seats on them that were a little bit bigger, a little spacious.
Maybe that's where they messed up. Because I remember the article, one of those cards cost $1 million.
Oh, my God. Are we really paying off a debt?
Because they can drive themselves. That's why. But it's just they need someone on there.
Yeah.
The trains?
The trains can actually drive themselves.
Maybe that's what it is. Like, some of the small things that we think don't cost that much probably cost a lot more.
Yeah, but that's why I think that even with a $2 fare from everyone that takes the train every single day, they've been making millions, and that debt itself would have been paid off by now.
I don't know. Maybe somebody's just not good with managing the money.
I think that's what it is. Or somebody is good with managing the money, but they're managing it into their pocket.
MTA embezzlement.
Scandal came out.
Mm-hmm. I'm like, what's that guy's name? Bernie Madoff?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they say he made off with their money.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, God, that's terrible.
You see, but that's why I like my humor, because it's like, I can go morbid. Yeah. But I can go corny, too.
Exactly. Bernie Madoff. Made off with your money.
Yeah, I just thought that was shade when I heard that news reporter say that.
I always felt bad because I didn't feel bad for that story. Because, like, there was this couple on TV that was like, you know, he ruined our lives. We can't go on our family vacation.
Aww.
And I'm like, I never go on a family vacation. We never can go on a family vacation.
Yeah.
Like
he didn't really take from,
he
like,
stole from rich people.
Exactly. The he only thing is he didn't steal from dirt broke people.
He wasn't like a Robin Hood. He just stole it and kept it.
Yeah.
Like, he didn't steal it and then give it to people. He just
he should have gave some. That's what he should have done.
Yeah, because then people wouldn't have been sold.
Yeah. He should have gave it to somebody. Like, we, like, kept some of it, but gave, like, a lot of it to other people. That's where he messed up. He could have ended up being a hero in the eyes of
a few people, yeah.
Lower class.
Yeah, because, I mean, if he still wants to send me a check, I'll take it. It's no problem. Okay, so this next story is about Willow. I'm going to be honest, I don't know anything about it. I just know people just sold.
Instagram picture.
Yeah.
People are so salty or what?
Do you know about this stuff?
I mean, I've seen the picture.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah.
I haven't seen it.
Yeah, I've seen comments. Why is nobody raising this girl? And I'm like, okay, what does she do?
Oh, that's the picture?
Mm-hmm.
You see, people are such prudes these days. You see, they're insecure about their sexuality. So if somebody brings up something about sex or wears anything that has an innuendo of sex, there we go. Oh, that girl's a slut. She needs help. She needs to be raised. Jesus, take the wheel.
I think in this case, it might be because of her age more so. Because, I mean, like, I'm looking at the picture right now. It's probably because she's so young, and I can see how, I mean, that's inappropriate for her age. Because how old is she?
Also, she's 14. But yeah. It's also, like, it's nipples. Like,
yeah,
they
exactly.
aren't. Even, like, there's been scientists that say, like, nipples aren't really sexual objects. We just made them that way.
Exactly. Not only that, but babies are exposed to nipples.
Exactly.
Babies from very young ages are exposed to nipples and breastfeed.
Yeah, but...
And then you're supposed to be able to breastfeed until somebody's 5.
Yeah.
Oh, that's too long.
And you know what? There's actually... There's no... It's not illegal for women... to actually, like, be exposed and shirtless. So for her to have a fake picture of breasts is ridiculous, regardless of her age.
Yeah, it's a
but
t-shirt.
The thing I was going to say, the thing is, though, you have to pay attention to what society's conditioned to. And while logically, you know, it might make sense that, oh, it's not actually, like, a big deal or a sexual thing, but if society sees it that way, then it is. You know what I mean? It's all about perception.
Perception, but we need to correct society and say, you know what? You guys need to calm down.
But it's just not there yet. And so she's wearing the shirt in present time, where society is not caught up with that kind of idea. So
it hasn't. And it's slowly changing, you know? Even Miley Cyrus is doing things that, you know, everyone was like, oh my God, she shouldn't have done that. Oh my God, look at her age. Oh my God, she was pole dancing. No, people are changing it little by little. And I do see progress. And even to 14-year-old Willow Smith, she sees it too. She's like, you know what? There's nothing to be ashamed about. I'm going to wear this shirt and I'm going to post it on my Instagram.
Well,
you know?
And the thing about her, okay, I can get everything that's from my side, but the whole pole dancing thing, okay, now that's where, like, she was too young to be doing all that now. At the time, she was too young for that.
Oh, she was not really pole dancing, though. They said that she was pole dancing, but I didn't see no tricks. Like, all she did was really hold on to the pole and bend down.
It was the ice cream cart.
It was an ice cream cart, too, with a pole. Like, Miley Cyrus did not do no split, no nothing. She didn't do no flips or, you know, she wasn't spinning on it.
Oh, okay, then. I didn't see it, so I was just saying. Like,
she can't dance anyway.
Because when you say pole dancing, that's what comes to mind, so.
Well, yeah, but if you really saw the video, like, honestly, like, Miley Cyrus didn't do anything that was crazy at all. Especially when she was still, like, trying to keep up with that Hannah Montana look.
And also, pole dancing isn't sexy.
It's such an art.
With no clothes on or on the pole. If someone was wearing a full suit on the pole, people would be like, what is going on?
Not only that, but pole dancing has gotten so much shade, but it's such an art, you know? Even in, like...
Yes, it is. Because that thing is hard to get up there.
It's hard, and it's honestly, like, it puts you in shape so well. Like, if you really do it, it's basically gymnastics on, like, a metal pole. That's what it is. It's graceful. It's nice. Like, I even, you know, I was watching Beyonce's... Rihanna's. Rihanna's music video, Pour It Up, and there were actual, you know, pole dancers there, and this one girl was just holding the pole, but she was walking, and she was in midair, too. She was, like, pretending that she was walking, and I thought that was so amazing.
Also, with the whole shirt thing, I felt like if she was a boy and she had on a shirt like that, they wouldn't really have much to say. They would be like,
so you think if it was Jaden, they would have just been like, oh, Jaden's just being Jaden.
Yeah, boys will be boys kind of thing. They would be like that.
But
the fact that she is she's a female, they're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe you put that on and stuff like
that. And that's something that society has to change their outlook on, is that females aren't this type of way anymore. It's not the 1700s.
yeah, females should be able to wear what they want to wear and stuff like that. Like, some things, like, I mean, like, stuff that fits you now. That doesn't mean, like, wear things, like, if you have, like, a gut to wear, like, a half shirt or something like that. No, that doesn't
matter. Let it hang out. Let it hang out.
No. Oh, that's what Justin Bieber did, though.
Oh,
we'll get to that next.
But that's not even on the list.
Oh, it's not?
No.
Oh,
my God. Little okay. thing.
Aw. Oh, you don't know, though.
Okay, so you guys want to talk about Iggy and Azealia? I know Tanisha's like, yay.
Iggy versus Banks.
I don't even.
Or Azealia versus Azealia.
I like that. They should both name an album like that and work together.
Cola?
No. Ooh.
No, they said no right away.
Okay.
I would really like to hear 212 Fancy. Now.
212 Fancy.
Mm-hmm. That would be a hot song.
No, it would not. It would be confusing.
Wow. First of all, 212, I think is confusing in general because I thought she was talking about New York. Because of our area code.
Oh.
But when you listen to... Huh? She was?
Wasn't she talking about a girl, like, being fake?
Oh, I don't know. I just hear... I hear a few things now and there, and it don't sound like New York.
No, yeah.
But 2-1... Because New York is fancy. So 212 Fancy. We don't need Charlie X. We don't need Lazy J, and we don't need Charlie XCX. They can be in the remix.
So did anyone actually see, like, the interview that Azealia did on Hot 97?
No.
I heard about it, though.
Is that the one where she was talking and she said that she believes she's hip-hop or something like that? She changed hip-hop? Or is it the one where she did her freestyle?
Wait, who are we talking about? Azealia?
Azealia.
I guess we should call them Banks and Iggy.
Yeah, thank you.
Are you talking about the one she did with Ebro?
Yes, I saw.
Is that when she was crying?
Yeah, she
started crying.
I heard all about it, but I didn't see it. I know she talked about appropriation and you know, sexism against black females, of course.
See, here's the thing with Azealia Banks for me. Now, I like her and Iggy both, but I like, especially like Azealia, though. I feel like no one holds a candle to her, really. She's very talented. But the thing is, though, is she's so, like, I feel like she could be really emotional sometimes. And I feel like Ebro was really, if you listen or watch the interview, I feel like he was really trying to impart some, like, good knowledge, like, that she could grow from, but she was too busy, like, she was in her emotions too much. And so she wasn't getting the message. And I don't know, that just kind of turned me off a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know. Just between them, I would have to say, like, with art, I think you should have a talent. Otherwise, you know, and I personally, like, even with, like, any type of art, like maybe painting and sculpting, like, don't just draw me a box and say, here, this is worth millions. Like, no. Justin was even saying earlier that it's not really about the skill. It's about the hype of the person that really sells it. You know? And just between them, I don't know. I feel like there's not that much going on with them. It's just the hype. You know? Iggy's not that great, and Azealia's been talking way before she's had an album.
My personal opinion, I think, I like both of them, but my personal opinion is Azealia is definitely a lot more talented than Iggy, but Azealia's, probably saying her name wrong, Azealia Banks, a personality just ruins her for me. Does anyone agree?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like she
I was
used that entire... Sorry, go ahead.
No. Say what you say.
Oh, I feel like she used that whole entire Hot 97 interview as a way to, like, just attack Iggy because I don't know if you guys know, like, they've had, like, a beef for, like, the longest time, like, even before Fancy was, like, this big hit. Like, Azealia was just going after Iggy really hard, and I just felt like, I don't know, if you're gonna say something about cultural appropriation, there's so many more artists that you can go after instead of Iggy. Like, you can go after Justin Timberlake, Adele,
Justin Bieber,
Sam Smith,
Justin Bieber. Like, there's so many more artists you can go after. But the fact that she just went specifically after Iggy, it just makes it seem like
it's a name thing.
It's like a personal vendetta.
She's salty about the name.
Well, and she's salty about, like, the success that she's had instead of her.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's the thing. Like, Azealia wasn't really coming out with anything.
But, I mean, 212 was a big hit in the 90s.
Oh, my God. Exactly. She was throwing mad shade at people while she had nothing. There was this meme I saw that was like...
I wouldn't do that to... Because Iggy came out, Iggy has albums, like, yeah. has music out, and she just got her hit.
I know. That happens sometimes.
Exactly, I mean, I understand exactly why Iggy is more popular. She's, like, it's like the Macklemore thing. Like, they're more accessible to different people instead of Azealia. Like, they're more safe. You know what I mean? Yeah. And, like, I get where she came from on that point, but it just came across the wrong way to.
And I feel like the only reason Azealia Banks is, like, really relevant again is because she's been throwing people under the bus like this, you know? And now she comes out with this album. Now everyone's like, well, are you going to bring it, Azealia? Now everyone's listening to the album just to see if she, like, if she's as much talk as she is. Like,
She's talented, though. Yeah, the album's good now. I will say, I feel like she is very valid as an artist. And, you know, with or without the trash talk and the feuds going on Twitter or whatever, I think her music speaks for itself.
Yeah, some artists you have to separate the art from them because, like,
but you can't separate it when, like, that's the main thing that people hear from her is the Twitter beefs and her starting stuff.
I kind of do that with, like, because this is some celebrities, like, I like what they do, but if I ever get into their circles, we're not going to be friends, like, because, like, you suck. And I think Iggy and Banks both are people that just, like...
There was, like, this meme I saw, and it said, Azealia Banks be that kid in the back of the class making fun of everyone's projects when she didn't even do one.
Oh. That's so shady.
It is really shady, but that's why it's like she made fun of people so much for their music and was trash-talking people. Then she comes out with this album now everyone wants to hear because she's, I guess, made herself to be this type of expert on music.
But I don't know, like, her story. Like, why didn't she come out with an album? Like,
exactly.
She had a lot of, like, labor problems.
Okay.
Yeah, she did. She had problems with the label. When she first came out with the mixtape and stuff like that, she was trying to, the label was just like, we need stuff for the radio. We need stuff for the radio. And she was just like, look, let me just be me as an artist. Like, I have a whole bunch of ideas and stuff. Trust me, it's going to work out. But the label wasn't hearing that. Like, they didn't want to have to deal with nothing with her creative ideas. They weren't trying to be patient with her. They just wanted radio plays.
That's why I kind of feel like, you know, she takes things out on people that aren't very talented but are just, like, trending. Iggy Azealia was trending. And I feel like you really, like, you know, they're just doing what they want to do, too. You know, Iggy Azealia, I think she's all right. I don't think she's the best. She's definitely not the best, you know. But I feel like she's doing what she's wanted to do, was be famous and sing, you know, or rap, whatever.
Yeah, please don't say sing.
and the fashion.
The thing that I find the weirdest is she'll come after Iggy Azealia, but she won't come after Lana Del Rey, who's her best friend. Like, Lana Del Rey, like, has been, like, put under fire for, like, appropriation. Like, in her Ride video, she was called out for, like, appropriating Native American culture and stuff like that, and Del Rey isn't even, like, her real last name, so yeah. I think it's weird that she'll, like, completely ignore that and just go completely after Iggy.
She's not the only, okay, so as far as Sam Smith and Adele, I feel like they're doing it correctly as far as doing soul music and stuff. It's just the magazines and stuff that try to make it so that people won't like them. Like putting his putting Sam Smith on the page of V, I think that's what it's called, and they were just like, oh, the new face of soul or something like that. And it was just like, he never said that. That was a magazine printing. Like, he never said that's who he was.
Am I the only one that doesn't consider him soul?
It doesn't matter. He's not what soul. He never said that he was soul, though.
I consider like, him just, soul.
I just feel it's just not enough just, soul, though.
Yeah.
He's just doing, like, I feel like he's doing his music correctly. Adele is doing her music correctly. As far as, she did go after other people besides Iggy.
Or did
she went after what's his face? Action Bronson.
Yeah.
She went after
Yeah,
because nobody like all these other people she went after, but
did she go after anyone else relevant?
But that was sort of after the
That's
fact.
The thing. That's the thing though. Everybody's paying attention to the fact that she went after Iggy because she's the most newest relevant person, I guess. At this very moment, and the reason why she can't go after the big stars is because she's not on that level yet. You can't be going after stars like that. That's on like the top level. That's how you get blackballed. Like nobody's gonna buy your music. Like they'll straight like shut your stuff down. So
I mean, bitch, she's kind of already like burned a lot of bridges, though. When you think about it,
yeah,
Azealia.
Yeah, she did. That's only because she's not like well, Solange. And a few other artists applauded her on her being, like, not holding her tongue when it comes to music and people, like, because I felt like the reason why she doesn't like Iggy so much is mostly because she's not talented as she is and the fact that she feels like she stole her name.
There are a lot of people that are just not talented, you know, that are on the radio. And radios just want what plays and what's popular, and I feel like it's a big phase that's going on with music. And I feel like a lot of people are really taking it personally because they're not being played, and I feel like it's just what's happening right now, that it's trending, that this music is a big phase that everyone just wants to listen to. And, you know, eventually people will get tired of useless music.
But how do we fix, like, people who are just molded into stars versus talent shining to become a star? Like,
I mean, and I feel like it's going to happen really soon because even J. Cole recently came out and talked about Iggy, too. He was just like, in one of his verses in his song, he was just like, Iggy's gonna go and win the Grammy or something like that, and I'll just try to pretend, like, I'll just try to crack a smile. Like, he's gonna have to do that because it's ridiculous.
I don't think that's something you can really fix, though. I mean, people like what they like, and if people keep choosing to go towards that kind of music, then that's what producers or whatever are gonna keep putting out because that's what sells.
Exactly.
But also what is promoted.
It's not personal. It's all business. You know, and I know and I that music is, you know, great art that people, you know, take to the grave with them. But at this point, it's just something that's trending and it's something that's just business. It's nothing personal against real artists, you know. And, you know, Iggy's doing what she wanted to do with her life. It's not like she's being fake about it. It's not like she never wanted to sing or rap or she never wanted to be famous. She's doing what she wanted with her life, you know. And people are throwing her under the bus. Like, there are a lot of big artists that, you know, aren't original, especially Beyonce. Beyonce does not write her own music. And she's seen as a god.
You better not say that.
I didn't say it. I didn't say it. If I don't hear from you in a couple days.
The beehive will come. Like, you better whisper that thing. Like.
Oh. Well,
we are talking about people. It's nothing. Like, I do love Beyonce's music. I do, you know. But honestly, she doesn't write it. She doesn't write it,
you
which is the truth.
Clean that up.
Yeah, you better clean that up.
Oh my god.
People are turning this podcast off.
It's not only that, but like, I mean, I like Beyonce too. Well, I like some of her music, but I don't. In actuality, I don't think she sings that well. Like it's no shade. I love watching her perform, and I like her music, and it's very it's entertaining and stuff, but I don't, I mean, when you compare her to even, like, I don't know, Kelly Rowland, I think Kelly Rowland sounds better.
Yeah, I think Kelly was the better singer in the group as well.
Yeah,
I just don't think Beyonce sings that well, but I think it's a mixture of she was just here for so long, and then, you know, she's just a good combination of things.
And she's a great entertainer. Yeah. She can do it all with, like, flames in the back while doing all these bends and everything.
But then it's also, you got to get to the point, and I'm sorry to, like, go in on Beyonce, but you got to get to the point of she already had all of that money to build, like, to be what she is, like, from Destiny's Child. So give anybody a whole bunch of money and a good team and a father on a Grammy Academy, and you see what you can do.
Exactly.
But so did Kelly and Michelle. They had the same opportunities.
Yeah, that's the thing. I don't have no.
But they didn't have Matthew on their side like Beyonce. And we know Beyonce did a few shady things, like releasing singles on the same day that her former colleagues were.
Okay.
I mean, that's not her fault, though. If somebody, I mean, she decided to release it the same, even when she went off on sabbatical, Kelly could have released her music then. That's
why we have to work around Beyonce.
Yeah.
Well, that's
like she done made. See, that's the thing. Like, this is why Walmart can't be in New York, because it will kill all the other businesses.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes Walmart need to be where ain't nobody else at. Maybe Beyonce needs to go to New Zealand for a little while and be on their charts.
She was away. She was off the map as far as music-wise, putting music out. And Kelly didn't do nothing.
When?
When has Beyonce
ever been off the map?
No, I'm talking about, like, as far as music out. Like,
how are you off the map in the Capitol?
Wow.
I'm saying, like, she didn't put no music out for a year. And Kelly could have used that time. And she didn't. But back on the...
But when are you talking about, like...
Remember that time she took that year off and she went traveling and whatnot?
You do realize Kelly releases the album, like,
Kelly
all the time. There's Miss Kelly. There's, I don't know, what was that? What was the latest one?
Kelly's album?
Yeah.
Talk That Game.
Talk That Game. Talk A Good Game. Talk A Good Game.
Like, why would you put a stop? But no, I feel like she put out music that I was just like, why though? She need a better team. That's what that is.
Yeah.
But Beyonce done bought all the best people.
And, you know, it's just business. It's nothing personal, you know? People that, you know, are just trending will be on top. And that's something that, you know, we all just have to accept for
the
time
being.
No,
but it is personal. It is an attack.
It's personal.
Because if I build a supermart, if I build a Walmart across the street from 8 mom and pops, that's a personal attack against the mom and pops, because they're going to have to close. They're not going to be able to compete.
Yeah.
So it is a personal attack to me.
Also, getting back to Iggy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not like Iggy says that she feels like she is adding to hip hop and stuff like that. And she says that she knows her history on hip hop, and she didn't just all of a sudden decide to do this. When she didn't even know one of the legends that was speaking to her on Twitter. And then she goes as far as to make jokes about being a slave master. And then
she apologized for that.
I mean, like, I feel like, of course she would apologize for it, because then everybody's going to think that she's racist, even though she makes other racial, like, jokes and stuff on Twitter.
But so does Azealia, too. She makes racial jokes, too.
Yeah, I feel like Iggy Azealia and Azealia Banks are both terrible on Twitter.
And I don't mean
they're
to,
just
like...
terrible, like, personally. Like, personality-wise, they are kind of not the best people.
I mean, I know this is unfair to white people, but there's a difference between a white person saying something racial and a black person saying something racial, because there's power dynamics between a white person and a black person.
Yeah.
So if a black person's extremely racist, it doesn't translate into society, opposed to a white person being extremely racist. Well, then that's when legislation gets passed.
Yeah.
So,
but I feel like Azealia takes it to, like, the next level too, though.
Well, because it's personal for her. Like, she really, like if put them in a room together, we, like, somebody might swing.
Yeah.
I feel like she feels so mad that she's she's getting all this hype and stuff like that behind her for the simple fact that she's a new thing. Like, she's like, we have to, like, we just have to put it into layman's terms. Like, she is Caucasian. She's new. That's what's new. And she's a female. So that's new to hip hop. And that's why she's getting so much hype behind it. And Azealia is mad about that because, like, not only does she feel like she's still her name, but she's getting hype behind it. And she feels like she's racist. This is Azealia Banks saying that, like, she actually feels like that's what she feels about her. So it's like, why wouldn't anybody be mad about that? If you think somebody stole your name, then try to steal your talent, your type of talent, and then make more money off you, off the thing that you work way harder on and are more good at.
I don't get the whole stealing name, because who cares about Azealia?
Exactly. Like, Azealia really wasn't doing anything, you know?
But who is Azealia?
Iggy say she chose a name from, like, her street name plus, like, a pet's name. That's how she came up with that name.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
So she mad about a dog's name?
And her street name?
Yeah, I think it was random. I don't think she actually tried to, from what I understand, she didn't try to steal it.
I mean, but it's like, well, who, like, okay, it's like, okay, you stealing Beyonce. Well, you trying to be somebody. You stealing somebody nobody knows.
Yeah.
Like, what's that?
I don't know, because she had problems with T.I. and her at the
same time. I think T.I. is more guilty by association than...
Yeah. I personally don't think Iggy Azealia is racist. I don't think she's racist. I think she said some stupid things that were, like, really bad on her part, but I don't really think she's racist. And...
Well, she's not racist in the sense of...
Yeah, and hatred.
She's not going to put on her hood on the weekend, but...
I really don't think, you know, just because of your color, the color of your skin, you should only be allowed only one genre to go into.
No, it's not even that. Eminem was allowed to be in hip-hop, and it was just like, yeah, they gave him a hard time, but then he was like, whoa, he got these lyrics, yo. Like, listen to him. Let's give him a chance. Like, but when you listen to Iggy, it's just like, oh, okay, well, that was cute. It's not like, whoa, we should give her
it's like pop rap.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is that Iggy isn't, like, that great of a rapper.
She's not. That freestyle was bad.
Oh my god.
The flashing
How did your freestyle come off your album and then it's memorized and then it still sucks? Like, I don't get it. Like, how does that calculate? Usually if you memorize something, it's like, oh, yeah, some people, it's not just her, and he's not the only culprit. Some people, when they do freestyles, it's already memorized. But how does your memorized freestyle still suck? Like, I don't get it.
Yeah.
Well, I feel like that's sort of like asking Rihanna to, like, sing a cappella. That doesn't mean, like, she isn't good. It's just, she's just not great.
Yeah.
Wow. No, I'm sorry. Like,
Rihanna, I'm singing
acapella. Yeah.
Video.
I know they make fun of her for that Star Spangled. I mean, no, when she sang Hero.
Yeah, that video just popped in my.
But
mind,
like, many of people said, don't ever touch Mariah Carey's song. So, there you go.
Wait, she tried to sing Hero.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see that after this.
Do you?
Yes.
Yeah, I even saw that one. I don't know. I feel like sometimes people just... Things happen, you know?
But I will say, though, that...
Because I know Iggy Azealia is not that great, but I feel like things really do happen sometimes because Mariah Carey, a legend, the Christmas thing, she was a little dead on that part.
But I think Azealia, I think Banks kind of, I think she should have shut up and let, because now everyone's like, now it's even hyping her up more, Iggy. And it's like, Iggy could have been just that one album. You know, we don't know what, like, even like Nicki Minaj took a dip. I'm sure she came back with Anna, my Anna kind of don't. But
ooh,
she
that's still, my song.
I know. But and even the, like that was her only hit too, that Anaconda. I mean only Nikki? Kinda. Huh? Nicki, yeah, her only, well not her only hit ever, from but like from the album. I mean only kinda did alright, but
well, and 212 was a big hit again.
It wasn't.
Yeah, that was the only hit.
It was a hit, but I don't know if it was a big hit.
Yeah, I know.
It probably was a big hit overseas because it's more of an overseas sound.
It wasn't a hit in America though. It was overseas.
It's because it's not popular. It's not the sound right now in America, so therefore it will not be a hit in America.
I mean,
no,
I do
you
like
can
the
make,
album.
You can make any like you gotta work. Because look at all the British people that, like, all the British people, like, got hits here. Sam, Jesse, Ed.
Adele.
Ella. Well, Adele, yeah. Adele
Ellie
hasn't
Goulding,
released.
Yeah.
Ellie Goulding, too. I was talking about Ella
okay,
Henderson.
Okay, look at, okay, the, all the people that you named, though. Look at their background, though.
Because like, they're white?
No, not just that, but the fact that these people are coming from overseas. Mm. So that's like, that's foreign. And like when it comes to America, we love everything foreign. Even though that, I know that's weird, right? But it's just like, we love the foreign cars, the foreign food, the foreign, some men like the foreign women. And when you bring foreign, they'd be like, oh my gosh, that's the new main attraction. Let's look and see what they have. Like,
I don't think it's the same for like the British singer.
No.
Because not like a lot of them, you if you didn't know, you wouldn't have known. Like just like who was Jessie J? You didn't know she was British.
Yeah,
and I told
didn't
you,
know she was British at all.
And then she was talking.
She has a terrible voice when she talks, but she's amazing at singing.
You should just sing when
she
talks.
She just sing all the time. She's one of those people.
Oh yeah, Mariah has a horrible speaking voice too. I think the people with the worst speaking voices have the best singing voices.
Yeah.
Because Whitney's voice was so raspy and I'm going to stop talking, just sing.
Well, hey. Had some hope with that, though.
Well, we know her singing voice. But I still think her singing voice would have came back eventually.
No, I'm not talking about her singing voice. I'm talking about her regular voice, too, as well with that.
But her talking voice was always... Like, I seen old interview. I mean, I guess it was okay more when she was younger.
Did anyone watch the Whitney movie on Lifetime?
No,
not yet.
We talked about that last week, right? Or no, maybe I was talking to somebody else about that, but no, I haven't seen that.
No, I didn't see it either. I'm not into biopics like that.
Yeah, I didn't see that one, and I didn't see the Aaliyah one.
I do love the memes Lifetime presents.
Yeah.
That is the best thing.
Yes.
Those are great.
John Witherspoon, playing Maya Angelou. Now that was amazing. So, Iggy. I still think she can die out really soon.
Yeah.
She is going
She definitely will die out really soon.
And that's why I'm like, this is a phase. This is a phase of like music that's just trending. That it's only, it doesn't have great quality. It's just trending. That's what people want it to hear.
But the thing is, you keep saying that, but I don't think like lesser quality singers making more hits is. I think that will always be the thing. Just like, I mean, that happened with the Supremes. You had Florence Biller, the soul singer, pushed it aside and Diana Ross take over. And if that can happen back in the 60s, then yeah, it's going to keep happening and it still does.
I guess, but it doesn't help when you constantly like throw that person's name on your Twitter feed.
I just think like I think it happened less back in the day because people were just smarter.
Yeah, people were looking for quality back then cuz a lot of people did not make it, and a lot of people, like when what's that guy, Little Richie, James Brown, there are people that were trying to, like, do what they did, and they would, all they would do was just work harder and put music out that they couldn't copy, put styles out, dances and everything that they couldn't copy. that only they could make and people would look for them to do instead of like, oh, we'll find somebody else. That's why I feel like now when it comes to music, if you're going to put music out, you got to make sure that's the best thing you could ever do. Like, that nobody else could copy what you just did. And and Azealia Banks, I feel like that's her problem right now. She's putting too much focus on, like, yes, she should say something. I feel like, yes, she is right to say something. She should say something. People need to know this, these things that's going on. But she also needs to work just as hard on her music and promoting and stuff. Like, give a little bit energy to that and most of your energy on your work. Your work should be most important right now.
Yeah, I mean, she doesn't have a label right now, so she definitely has to, like, put the extra work in to get music out there.
Yeah.
Her music is good, though.
Yeah, it, especially Chasing Time. Yes. I love that song.
Yeah,
I
love some of the songs on the album are really good.
Yeah, like, she, and I like the producers that she picks. Like, she just, I feel like she is, like, she can become a genius if she would just put all of that energy and creativity and thinking into that besides using, like, this time to, like, yeah, she should point out the wrong that's being done because then the public won't know and they will just rock with it and stuff like that. We need to know what's going on. But at the same time, like, she should put all that, like how Ebro was trying to tell her, put all that in her music and continue to make good music. Just put all, just all the projects, like the videos that she makes and the ideas that she put in the video, I felt like those are really good and stuff like that. Like, she just, I don't know.
Yeah, hate, like real hate music and real love music always, you know, succeeds better than the pop, bubblegum pop. Because like, All of Me came out of nowhere by John Legend. That came out of nowhere. And boom, number one. Was that Take Me to Church?
Oh, by Hozier or something? Yeah.
Where did that come from? I mean, you know, it's just like... And then Anaconda, of course, Anaconda was a hit, but it went up, and but then it came right back down, and it fell fast. So...
What did you guys hear? What?
Well, that's because I feel like Nicki... She's not, like, she's just trying to make her coins right now. When Nicki is trying to rap, she can rap. Like, I've listened to her freestyles and stuff like that. So it's just like, I feel like she should go back to that. Even though people, that's not going to make her money, though. That's the thing I feel like she's most concerned with. That's not going to make her money.
I think maybe she's trying to clean it up, like, little by little. I just don't think Nicki Minaj has the right to ignore that she's got incomplete surgery done on her whole body.
Oh my gosh.
You know, what? I'm just like, you are selling your body in some part of this. Don't deny that. Don't sit here on your 10 asses and tell me that your music is not about it.
She said that?
No, I remember she was in like some interview and she was like, "Oh, well, that question is pertaining about my body and I don't want to answer that." And I was like, excuse you? That's what made you famous. You take those clothes off right now, miss, because that's what you all about.
Well, if that's what she want to do, if she don't want to talk about it, she don't want to talk about it. Like,
yeah.
I feel like if she has a right to say she don't want to talk about something right now. Like,
I feel like we let celebrities off the hook too much, though.
We do.
Like, they rich. Yeah, talk about it. Like, you rich.
Exactly.
Like,
and
you
why,
already won.
Why are you rich, though? Because sex sold for you.
But I mean, there's still people, though, and, like, money isn't everything. I mean, it's something. Don't get me wrong, but it's not everything. And, I mean, I agree. If, you know, it's a personal thing she doesn't want to talk about, like, it's difference between who they are when they get up on stage and who they are when they're off the stage. And, like, that's, you know, if they're being themselves and they're like, well, the me here doesn't want to talk about it, then... I think that's okay.
It's like not being in the mood. Sorry to use it as like a thing. Like, you know, say if somebody, you know, your significant other wants them, you'd be like, well, I'm just not in the mood right now. I don't feel like being sexy today. Like, why can't I just be regular? Like, she like, maybe that day she just,
well, I don't care if she want to throw on sweatpants. I mean, I've been seeing those pictures
and
of
that's
Iggy
the thing. That's
looking
the thing.
Basic.
In the interview, she wasn't acting like conservative at all. Like, she didn't even set the, I guess, the, she didn't set it from the start. that she wanted to be taken serious, you know? She had her hair down all nice, and she had her makeup just right, and she had full-on cleavage.
I mean, Nicki is a bird from Brooklyn, and you hear that every time she talks.
Queens. No, she's from Queens. Yeah.
All right, right. Little Kim is the bird from Brooklyn. She's the bird from Queens.
Yeah.
I don't go to Queens like that because there's desert lands over there.
Yeah.
But...
except for they mall. I love they mall because the Chinese food in there is banging. Oh my god.
Oh, you miss it, right?
Oh my god.
So good. Sorry. Okay,
let's move on to the Obama joke. State of the Union. I believe it's the sixth State of the Union. And what did he say? I have no more elections to run.
No, he said I have no more campaigns to run. I've already won both of them.
Yeah, I know that because I've already won both of them. I do like a president that has a personality.
Yes. And he was always a great talker, Obama.
Well, I don't know, because he does...
I know.
But I feel like everybody does that.
I mean,
but he does it at a normal rate. It's just like, all right. Like, I know they wrote the speech for you, like...
But I mean, that's the thing, like, he's not so computerized, you know? He could still get lost.
I mean, computers do that, too. They freeze.
Yeah, but it's not like, I think...
Like he's running low on RAM.
Like, I feel like that was a little more humane of him, like, that he did get lost like a little old man. Like, aw, somebody fix him.
No, but we already had 8 years of lost.
I know.
You know? And now, and it's funny how, like... Biden's kind of like the George Bush because of like Biden's like the little brother,
yeah,
or, you know, the little kid that's like
so stupid.
Except for now, he what to call it? Bush was the president, but Biden's just the vice president.
Mm. I mean, Dick Cheney was actual president, basically.
Yeah.
Wasn't George Bush the one that choked on the peanut or the pretzel?
He choked on the pretzel.
Yeah.
That's terrible. Like, some people, like, die in office. Others, you know, got killed while in office. You choked on a peanut.
Wow.
That's Georgie.
That's Georgie.
I feel like when people were saying that during that speech and stuff, and he was talking about things that, oh, he was saying a whole bunch of things and whatnot. And I feel like I hope that before he gets out of office, that he goes out with a bang. Like, he just keeps it real with us, like, 100% about, like, maybe not everything. Like, of course, there's a lot of things that as a president you cannot say and whatnot, because some people will go bonkers and whatnot and lose their mind.
Yeah.
But I feel like some things, like about how he feels about certain things, I feel like he should say it right before he leaves.
He's not.
I think he will.
Because he doesn't, because right now Republicans look really bad.
Yeah.
So he doesn't want to give them any type of leeway in the, what is it, 2016 election?
I think so, yeah.
So... he's not going to say anything. I mean, Republicans look bad on their own most of the time anyway. So,
but yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, even if he does say something wild, I feel like by the end of the week, they will take the, like...
I feel like if he says something, he'll be like Azealia Banks.
Yeah.
No, no. Well, okay. The president, I feel like he has a little bit more, like, experience than Azealia when it comes to stuff like that. So I feel like he'll know how to say it, and he'll know what, like, I just want him to be real and say how he felt, like, about Ferguson, about the...
Oh no, now you going off.
Yeah.
You going too crazy now. He might throw a little shade like he did at the, on the State of the Union, but yeah, he ain't gonna be like, y'all racist out here.
Exactly.
I feel like he should say exactly how he feels.
Maybe he doesn't have anything to lose.
Cause he don't. That's it. This is the last of the last.
He still gotta live the rest of his life.
Exactly.
Like, he ain't gonna get no job somewhere, or what he gonna see? Because he don't want to be. He don't want to be like George Bush. George Bush ain't got nothing to do but sit home and paint them ugly paintings. So he don't want to be like that.
He's so stupid. Them ugly paintings.
Did you see that paint of that dog?
No.
Like, who is hanging that up on anything?
Let me look it up.
So he don't want to be like that on the ranch.
On a ranch.
Painting ugly dogs. Okay, so we're gonna play a little game. If it's gonna be, is this headline true or false?
Okay.
Everyone can get one guess. Okay.
But
what?
Okay, I see how it's gonna. Okay, never mind. Sorry.
I mean, if you have questions about the rules, it's okay.
No, because I was gonna say, how is that gonna work? Are you gonna just ask everyone first and then tell us, and then that's, and then I just answer my own question in my brain? So I was just like,
okay. Oh, okay. Okay, first one. If you know it already, well, you know it. But Kevin Gates is banging his cousin, and he doesn't care who knows.
True.
False.
Victoria?
False. I hope it's false.
Catalina?
I'm going to go with true.
It's actually true. He made an Instagram video, and he even said it. And he said, I don't even care. I'm going to keep doing it.
Question, who's Kevin Gates?
Yeah. Some, I don't, he's some rapper, but I've never heard any of his songs.
Southern rapper. A lot of people down south listen to him. They really bang his stuff down here a lot. So, yeah.
Okay.
okay, next one. Oh, well, you guys won no prize, so congratulations. hold on, just let me pull up the link. Okay, Subway discovered to be using cockroaches in food. FDA to close U.S. Subway restaurants.
True.
False.
What was it again? I'm sorry.
Subway discovered to be using cockroaches in food. FDA to close U.S. Subway restaurants.
Oh, wait, all the restaurants?
It doesn't specify.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe false then. That doesn't sound right.
False.
False.
I don't know. I was right with truth. I'm going to go with true.
That's false.
Wait, what is this? Kevin Gates has reportedly impregnated his cousin.
Wasn't it, Tanisha, wasn't that you after after the yoga mat scandal came out and you had just bought a Subway sandwich?
Oh my gosh. Look, okay, let me tell you.
Wait, a yoga mat? I thought it was tire rubber.
Yoga mat.
I think it was yoga mat.
I thought it was rubber from a tire.
Well, isn't rubber's rubber? What's the...
Oh, well, I guess I have no argument.
It's a chemical made... there's a chemical in yoga mats, though.
Yeah.
Okay, so one time I went to Subway and I was eating, and I brought the sandwich, came home, sat down, and as I'm eating it and I'm scrolling through my phone, I ran across an article about Subway. So I opened the article and it says Subway is being under investigation for having some long ass chemical name for yoga mat in their bread. So I have a mouthful of yoga mat bread in my mouth. And I'm looking at the article like, no, this is not real. Please let it not be real. And then I found like several more links. I'm just like, well, I might as well finish the sandwich. So
I remember you on Skype. You were so mad.
Yes.
And I'm like, that was so hilarious that the day that story comes out, you just happened to go to Subway.
I don't eat Subway anyway. Before or after the scandal.
I haven't, you know what's funny? I haven't had it since the scandal, and the scandal was about them removing it from the bread. So it's like whatever damage has been done. So
yeah.
Okay, next headline is racist man tells a black woman to go sit in the back of the bus.
True.
True.
I feel like that could happen anywhere, so true.
False.
Okay. It is true. And it was right at this video, I've actually seen it. It was right after the Donald Sterling thing. And he actually mentions Donald Sterling as he's...
Oh, my God.
Because, like, you know how black people are. So, it's just like, she was like, well, why you want me to move? And he's like, Donald Sterling. Every black person's like, oh, God. And, okay.
That's the thing. Like, Donald Sterling, he had, like, he was supposedly, like, had the good guy thing. Like, I'm not racist. Look what I did for these people and stuff. But then then somebody catches him saying something racist on the low ski. Like, it's just like.
Yeah, because that's that Whoopi Goldberg stuff. Like, oh, he's not racist. He's my friend.
Yeah.
Like,
he's what? Not,
like, there are serial killers who have families. Like, that doesn't mean, like, that means nothing.
He's my friend.
And, it, like, not to, you know, but you can have friends that you think less of.
Mm-hmm.
Like this
no,
friend.
But like to be friends with somebody that really hates your guts, like, are you kidding me?
What?
There can be things that you dislike about a friend.
But I mean, but the thing is, racism doesn't necessarily mean KKK. Like, there's other levels of it. And I think a lot of people think you have to hate somebody, like absolutely hate, like want to spit in their face. And you not necessarily... y'all ready for the next one? Catalina left, so. Grandmother at 72 years old is having a baby with her grandson.
Oh.
I hope false.
Me too. I hope false.
Now this one was a little bit of a trick. But it is true. And... Okay, so the mother of the grandson gave him up for adoption. Grandson meets the grandmother. He's 26, she's 72. Apparently they fall in love and she's having they're doing a surrogate mother.
Okay. So it's not his biological grandmother.
No, it is his biological grandmother.
And they fell in love?
Allegedly.
Okay.
I mean, it's not like it was like his grandmother, like she brought him presents on Christmas and she made them cookies, but it's still odd. Like, I would think knowing that that's your grandmother would be the big enough turn off. Like, I mean, cousin, I mean, I guess it's debatable that everyone's our cousin in a way, at least further, you know, somewhere on the line. But grandmother, like, the age difference is already bad enough, like literally almost triple. Okay, Justin Bieber promises to only have sex with black women in February.
I can see that being true. It might be false, but...
Tanisha, what did you say?
True.
No, this is actually false. It's, but it was supposed to be like, he's apologizing for the things he's done in his past. So for Black History Month, he's gonna... He's going to treat black women.
Well, the reason why I said that is because I know how he feels about Nicki Minaj and how he feels about a lot of the black women artists. And that's only why I thought about it. I was like, that could be true. He kind of likes him some chocolate, so.
Nick Cannon to star as Tupac in new feature film.
True, unfortunately, true.
Are you like, what is wrong with people? I've seen that too. Why? Nick Cannon, of all people, he's gonna play a gangster? Like, no.
Ew.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to take that seriously.
Actually, the story is not true.
It's not true?
No. I know it's been getting around, but it's not.
It's not? Okay.
No.
Everything.
I mean, maybe now that it's been said, it'll be brought into light, but...
Oh, hopefully not.
They need to turn the light off, unscrew the bulb, break
the
bulb.
He doesn't even look that much like Tupac.
Don't they need somebody younger to play Tupac?
Exactly. Not only that, but wasn't there, like, a guy that worked at an airport that looked a lot more like Tupac? I saw it on, like, TMZ.
Why don't they just bring him from Cuba? We all seen the pictures.
I know, right?
No, seriously? What if it was that guy from the airport in Cuba?
The what?
You said the guy from the airport. I saw a picture of some guy that looked exactly like Tupac.
Yeah, on TMZ, I guess one of the reporters was at the airport trying to catch some celebrity, but they found, like, this guy that was, like, a security guard, and he looked just like Tupac. Mm-hmm. And they were like, so you've been working here the whole time?
He was also in the Midwest at a bar.
If it's a Lifetime movie, probably.
What?
Oh, you know, Lifetime don't care.
No.
I don't know, but what if he really is alive? Like, I kind of feel like, nah, he's not alive. Like, he died and whatnot. But then at the same token, it's just like, what if he is alive? And then he just comes out of nowhere, like, and starts singing, like, rapping one of his songs. Like,
I think that's when music would get better quality.
His first single is going to be with Iggy.
Oh, my God.
No, it's not. He's probably going to link up with, like...
No, let me... That would be so hot. Okay. It'll be... No, that year is going to be crazy. I think it'll be 2020, right? Iggy, Iggy, Azealia, and Tupac, right? We got Mariah and Nick doing a song together.
Not dead, but her music will be dead.
We got Mariah and Nick doing a song. His rap career is going to come back. Who else we got? We got Lil' Kim and Nicki Minaj. And these people not just doing one song. They're doing albums together.
Oh, my God.
Well, I always just, like, when Mariah and Whitney did that song, I would have loved to be in that studio. Just love.
The shade.
Yeah, because they both shade. So shady. I mean, Whitney isn't, like... Like, Whitney was more real with her. Like she wasn't trying to go for a joke. She was trying, you know, she's trying to cut off your head. But they probably were just cordial. Like, you know what? Forget it. We can't even, like, because they don't top each other. So it's just like, what happens? But anyway, next headline. K. Michelle hospitalized after butt implants reach freezing temperatures.
Oh.
True.
I hope true.
I'm going to say true.
You said you hope? Oh, my gosh.
You lucky Brianna here.
Yes, she stands for her. Oh, my goodness.
And I'm like, what has K. Michelle ever done to be... Anyway, that was false.
Oh,
I know, right?
I at least wanted K. Michelle to gain some interest.
She does. But
she does on her own, honey. She makes her own drama.
But I'm going to need, like, these black women to not, like, why are they always flipping out on Twitter? Like, you got K. Michelle, Tamar, Azealia. What is going on?
No, not all of them. It's just the...
Not all black women, but I mean those black women.
That Beyonce.
Well, Azealia, like, Beyonce don't even be on Twitter.
Beyonce's at home sitting on money laughing. And watching for when Kelly releases a single so she can release a single.
That's really creepy.
I mean, we know Beyonce's like, Beyonce, because it's like, okay. I mean, I don't think it happened like a lot, but it did happen that one time. I don't know what single it was. I think it was Like This. Wasn't the best song. I will give that to, you know, wasn't the best song for Kelly. But but Beyonce then released Why Don't You Love Me, or was it? Yeah. And it's like, lady, you had already released like 10 singles. You did not need to release that. I don't know. Hey, remember when she cut her out that picture on Instagram? Because y'all don't, like, you got a cat. Beyonce is shady. Like, because she can't, like, she's too high up there to really, like, speak freely. So she has to do little things. That's why she don't tweet, because she might get in trouble.
Yeah, because I feel like she'll slip up one day and say something. Because she is from Houston now, like.
Yeah, it's Beyonce. That is Beyonce from Houston. I know they changed to Beyonce when she got famous, but that was Beyonce.
Calendria.
That's not her real name. That's her real
Calendria.
Name.
Calendria. Oh, and what's Tanitra? Or that's Michelle Tanitra?
Tetris, I don't know.
Tanitra is Michelle's real name. Mm-hmm. What's Beyonce's real name is Beyonce?
I don't know. I just say that because...
That's what I'm about to say.
But, like, if you watch the one of the videos when she wins the award, it goes, and the winner is Beyonce.
Well, you know how, like, no shade, but you know how some, like, when white people say black people's names, they be trying so hard to pronounce it right. That's what my professor did the other day. He was like, Tynesia? I'd be like, you almost had it.
But how did they get your name wrong if it's Greek?
Oh my god. No, but you do have that extra I at the end, Tynesia.
But so what?
Like, it looks like it is Tynesia.
It's not. It's like, okay, even in, okay.
Well, excuse them for speaking English.
Yeah. They weren't trained in ancient Latin.
My name is not English, though.
So. I'm sorry. We in America. It's probably an English teacher.
And no, it wasn't.
Well, was it a Spanish teacher? And no. What language is your name?
It's Polish.
What? Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
You didn't tell her. Oh, that was y'all. You didn't tell us that.
No.
Now it's Polish.
Wait, your name is Polish?
Yeah, type it in Google.
We did. It said nah.
He did not type it that fast.
It is not Polish. I will tell you that, Tynesia. You better try again.
Floyd Mayweather signs away $10 million after reading contract wrong.
No, true. He did not.
Absolutely true.
That's false. That's one thing about Floyd, is he's good with his money.
Yeah, that was false. That would have been hilarious, though. I mean, I would have felt bad, but that would have been hilarious. Like, oh, how do you pronounce his name? Idris Elba? That's how you say it?
Idris Elba. Yeah, Idris.
Idris?
No, it's Idris.
Okay, we'll call him K. Michelle's obsession.
No, but he's actually, you know, Polish, so that's how I know how to read it.
Okay. My New Year's resolution is to only date white women.
Woohoo!
Who said that?
Idris Elba, my new man.
K. Michelle's obsession.
False.
I guess false.
I mean, K. Michelle could, like, turn you off, because, like, she just, like, she talk about him in every interview now.
My thing is, why would you even date her? Like, are you serious?
Yeah, they don't see, it's just, like, where did y'all meet? Like.
Yeah, like, how did you even meet him? Like, why didn't you go the other way? Did you not even hear about her? Like, why? Why did you do that to yourself? Like, he could have dated somebody else. Like, why didn't you come talk to me? Like, wait,
Did they actually date, or was it just like a?
Apparently, she got pregnant and lost the baby and stuff.
Because that's what K. Michelle liked to do. She did that. She stopped her birth control. She probably told him at first, oh, I'm on birth control. And then she stopped as soon as they started doing it so she could have something to talk about. Like, that's what she likes to do.
So she got something to talk about.
Oh, my God. That's not even just have a child, just something to talk about. That's crazy.
Something that she could cry about and stuff like that. Because that's what she do every relationship. She'd be like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. Like, it's like, why can't you just leave a dude? Just be like, oh, we not talking no more, and that's it. Like, do you really have to tell the world everything? Like, some stuff. Why do you think Beyonce is, like, where she at right now? Because she don't tell us nothing.
Yeah, because like, I still, there's so many things I want to know. And I'm hoping, like, at least, like, before you die, leave a book.
Yeah.
Like, because I need to know what Solange was so mad about.
In that elevator.
I need to know, is Matthew really Kelly's father? I need to know.
He is.
Like, there's so many things I need to know. And it's crazy. So, well, that was the last one I had.
All right, then.
Well, you gotta, that was the last one I had. So, I guess we're wrapping up now.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
All right, yeah.
Would anybody like to shout out their channel? All
right, now's the time to shout out the channels.
I guess I did it in the beginning, but my channel is the Midnight Hour Podcast on YouTube and iTunes. That's pretty much it.
And mine is the... Oh, can you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Mine is the Victorian Empire, and it's got all my social media on there, so you can find me there.
I'm tired.
My YouTube is...
KMichelleLover.com.
No. Mine's is Savvy.
Try back to
Savvy. Just type that in, search whatever, and you'll find me.
That was so inspiring. I can't wait to go check out the channel.
I know.
Yes. Oh my gosh, check it out.
She's probably really popular in Poland, though.
Mm-hmm. Because everybody got that name in Poland.
It's not the right one. You know, that's not the one. That's not the one I told you guys before. But I just said that.
I don't know. It changes every time you tell us a story.
It does. It really does.
It's Greek, Polish. Next time, be French.
It was not. I've never.
Next time, it'll be Portuguese.
No, that's not even. It doesn't even sound like it.
But anyway.
Anyways,
our channel is youtube.com/slowlistinyourface. Thank you so much, everyone, for listening. There will be clips on the YouTube channel.
Thank you. You
can listen on SoundCloud and iTunes momentarily. Thank you so much for coming, guys. And thank you so much for listening, people. Thank you. Bye.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.